one's gonna want those old toys. They're junk.
Fine. You have till Friday. Anything that's not packed for college or in the attic is getting thrown out.
Whatever you say, Mom.
We're getting thrown out, you idiot. That's what's happening.
What you just saw was Andy going off to college. Though what you did not know is that there's an Andy in all of us. For instance, here we see a young Christian Gonzalez. It is his first day of sixth grade at Gompers Preparatory Academy. Like any first day of school, Christian is both excited, but he's scared. He's a little nervous being in such a big school, wondering what the future will hold for him. However, he just found himself in room 17, Mr. Bench's room. Little does Mr. Bench know, he is about to ignite a passion in Christian. The passion is chess. Though as Christian grows older, he begins to lose his passion due to activities such as soccer. He also loses passion due to distractions, whether it was school or hanging out with friends. So, just like Andy in the video, Christian has come to a crossroad. Chase that passion down or let it fade away forever. So what does he do?
Good morning, faculty, students, class 2017, and Director Rivera. My name is Christian Gonzalez.
My name is Bruno Landa.
My name is Alejandro Martinez.
And welcome to our senior talk. The theme of our senior talk is how to reignite those lost passions we once had. What we will show, casing, is how to regain those lost passions.
Number one, figure out why you had the passion in the first place. One of the criteria we were given for our senior talk was choosing something that we had a passion for. So as a group, we came together and we said that we had a similar passion for chess. In today's world, there are many distractions around us. However, in the game of chess, you're on your own world. You have 64 squares, 32 pieces, and one opponent. Chess is not just a game of intelligence, it's a game of skill, endurance, and patience. Which leads us to our second tip in regaining a passion.
Tip number two, be involved with your passion. What we mean by this is to take every opportunity you get to interact, practice, or showcase your passion. One way we attract to reignite passions is by trying to keep this passion alive in our younger students, to reintroduce this passion into our older ones, and try to figure out why they fell in love with this game in the first place. One way we kept this passion alive is by putting our own GPA chess tournament. What we seen was excitement among students to be part of this experience. We've seen all the joy in younger students' faces when we first introduced this tournament. We ended up being floated over 60 students just to play chess in a single day. After advertising, setting up, and starting the tournament, we were able to see how just important this game is to some of our students here at GPA. Please enjoy this brief montage of some of the moments we were able to capture on camera.
Thank you.
As you can see, young or old, with epitome of joy, sportsmanship, and excitement. Please give a round of applause for our two GPA chess winners, 8th grader Aaron Ploneda and senior Daniel Sison. We were able to sit down with Daniel and ask him a few questions about his passion. Here's a quick video.
What sparked my interest in chess was the fact that I played with my mom pretty much almost every day during my childhood. It was a lot of fun, and I loved doing it. As I got older, I also entered high school, and my schedule got a whole lot busier. I also gained a lot more interest, so I didn't really have time to fit chess in my schedule. I would definitely love to play chess again. I had a lot of fun playing in tournaments and just playing with my friends and my parents. I hope I can do that again sometime. Organize your time. A lot of the times you just don't know how to place things or don't know when to do what. It takes a lot of commitment, and I understand it's a lot of hard work. But with hard work, it comes with your passion, so it all makes sense.
Our last tip to regain a passion is?
Number 3, share your passion with others. The second part of our senior talk was not reigniting a passion, but making sure passion for chess alive within our GPA students. What we would do on our free time is we would go out and look for students who needed someone to sit with, talk to, or maybe even play a game of chess. See, because our main goal was to, number 1, make sure everybody has someone they could sit with. 2, make sure everybody has someone they could talk with. And finally, make sure to keep that passion for chess alive within our GPA students. There's a reason why we call ourselves the Checkmates.
Over the past 3 months, we have noticed a change within ourselves. We noticed that we were coming out of our comfort zone, because usually our zone of comfort is our core group of 7 friends. However, we noticed that we were more willing to work and interact with younger students on campus. We also found ourselves taking on a lot of responsibility by planning and figuring out the logistics of putting events together on campus. And then we felt like our goal of reigniting the passion and keeping it alive, it worked. We got to see lots of kids getting excited to play the game of chess, whether it was for the first time or the 100th time. We felt like the tournaments that we created helped build a stronger community here at GPA, revolved around a single game.
As we grow older, we lose some passions and gain others. But do we really regain the ones we once lost? We would like to end our senior talk by sharing with you the parallel between our journey and the myth of Eurydice and Orpheus. Once upon a time, there was this couple named Orpheus and Eurydice. They were madly in love with one another. However, one day Eurydice was bitten by a snake and died. Orpheus was so sad that his love was lost to Hades that he traveled to the underworld. After a lot of hard work, determination, and skill, he was able to convince Hades to let Eurydice come back to the mortal world. However, Hades told Orpheus that as they traveled back to the surface, he had to hold Eurydice's hand, and she had to follow just behind him. Hades told Orpheus that if he just looked back for just a quick second, his beloved will be lost to the underworld for eternity. As they traveled, Orpheus became to become impatient and nervous that his loved ones no longer there. So as soon before they reached the surface, Orpheus looked back and seen how Eurydice was taken back to the underworld for eternity. It will be only once then Orpheus has passed away for the two lovers to be reunited once again.
We notice about the myth is that it paralleled a lot with our passions. Just like Orpheus, we chased our passions even after we felt like we've lost them. However, unlike Orpheus, we didn't get distracted and look back. We stayed focused, determined, and we persevered to regain those lost passions we once loved. And we hope you guys do the same.
So, whatever your passion may be, if your passion is art, then keep creating. If your passion is sports, then keep training. It doesn't matter what your passion is, as long as you keep trying. So we ask you now to go forth, chase those passions down, do not let that flame die. And thank you for listening. This concludes our senior talk.